Hi guys, this is BC Tech by Bubba Conte. So today we are going to continue from where we stopped in our last HTML project. In our last HTML project we did the heading tags, that is the H1 tags. So today we are going to dive more into HTML tags. Let's just go in and then open our Visual Studio Code Editor. Open your Visual Studio Code Editor again and then start on coding. Okay, here we have our, let's just move this. Okay, here we have our HTML document. So last time we did the heading tags, and so today we are going to do the p tags. The p tags, yes, they are the paragraph tags. So the paragraph tags are used to insert text into a HTML document. So to insert a paragraph or a text into a HTML document, can just less than p, greater than, and then less than this class p, and then greater than. So inside this is where we put our text. So Visual Studio Code has a default random text just like in Microsoft Word. So you just need to type lorem and then it will do the rest. You click enter and then the text is there. So let's save our document and go back to our browser and see. But before we go back to our browser, I want us to install another extension again, and which is Live Preview. So Live Preview will enable us to be able to sort of our browser will reload without us reloading it manually. So whenever we save in our Visual Studio Code Editor, it will reload in our browser immediately. So let's just go to extensions and then search for Live Preview. Live Preview here is there. I have installed mine, so you can just go in the Live Preview, install it and reload, and it will be there. So let's continue. So I have installed mine. I can save. So now if you want to open the Live Preview in your Visual Studio Code, you can just right click, open with Live Server is here. So open with Live Server, you can click it, or yesterday the shortcut is there, Alt L and Alt O, that will do the shortcut. But yeah, I see. Yes. Let's go to our browser and see. Yeah, the text is there now. So here we have our text. I think let's also insert another text, another paragraph tag P, and then image. Since we have installed image, if you have not, you can go to the extension and install it. Image, we just write P, and then since it has been brought to us as options by the Visual Studio Code, you can just press enter and that's it. So you can just also write lorem also. Visual Studio Code is so nice. Enter, and then the random text will come as we save in our browser. It has been reloaded. So let's also do another tag, which is called the img tag or the image tag. The image tag also enables us to insert images in a web page. So let's do that and see. Img, so it has already been given to you. Click enter, and then images, they have a source and alt. Okay, so source. The source of an image is the path of the image you are inserting, where it is stored, the location of the image. So the alt here is used for people that have visual problems. So that whenever they hold on the image, it will tell them this image is this or what the image is about. So the source here, you put the name of the image. So let's just go on and put an image inside and see inside our web page rather. So I have downloaded an image. I named it images.jpg. I included it in the project one folder. So you can just go to the web and download any free image and then save it in your project one folder. So since we have done that, so now all that I need to do, since my image and the index are in the same folder, I can just go there. I can just go to the source and write images. You see, Visual Studio Code will sort of try to tell you this image is there, or will tell bring the list of images that are there so that you can choose from what you have. So let's click. I can click on enter now, and then the name of the image there. So this image is .jpg. So the extension here .jpg is very important. This .jpg, like just as the document has a .html, this .jpg also tells the browser that this is an image. And images, they have various extensions. We have the JPEG, .png, and all those stuffs, other stuff rather. So JPEG and PNG are the most common extensions for images. So we just let's just save and see what we have in our web page. Let's save and then go to our web page. Yeah, we have our image, nice and beautiful. So we can also find the extension of our image by going to the folder. Let's just go to the folder, project one folder. It's in our desktop. Where's the project one folder? Yes, I have it here. Yes, you can. If the extension have not been given to you here, you can just go to the image, right click, go to properties, and then you see the extension of the image. This tells you the type of image you have. So you just have to take the extension. If it is PNG, go and write there PNG, or else the image will not load. So our alt text, we need to put something there. Let's say this is nature. This is nature. So this is nature. So the alt text also can also help users, even users who are who might go to a browser and then maybe for some reason there's maybe internet connection, and then the page did not load our images, then the alt text will come there, and it will appear telling, maybe giving some information to those users also about what the page is. So what the image is. I'm going nuts here. So it tells the users also what the image is about. So if we save, let's say, be mindful, the name of your image you put in source here must be exactly the same. The letter cases, and then this dot here must be there. So, and then the extension also, be mindful of that. It is not if the name of your image is image and you go and put their images, it will not load. So be mindful of that, the name must be exactly the same. So let's remove JPEG and see. Let's save, go to our browser, You see, so because I named the image wrongly, the image will not appear, but then the alt text will appear. This is nature, so the users will know what the picture is about. I think as well, this is a picture of nature, a picture of nature. I think this more is better than that. So let's see if, yeah, this is a picture of nature. So guys, thank you. I think we will stop here. In my next video, I will talk about anchor tags and then list elements, and then probably very soon we will get into CSS. So please subscribe and then like my videos for my upcoming tutorials that are coming. I have a lot of interesting things for you guys, so please subscribe and do not forget to like my videos also. So let's just correct this thing again. JPG. Yeah, let's save. Let's see. Yeah, now the image is back. So guys, thank you. Subscribe, like. Goodbye. Have a good day.